Joseph! Ludwig, I'm not deaf. What do you want?
You've been keeping track. What time is it?
1991.
Oh. I didn't realize it was so early.
What is it now?
It's an anniversary, surely.
Isn't it always?
No, but someone important.
It's Mozart. 200 years.
Oh, yes. Mozart. What, birth or death?
So young. Such a tragedy.
It's funny, isn't it? Him not being here.
It's an absolute scandal.
I mean, this is the Society of Composers. And he's not here.
I say to his father, he's the greatest composer of his age. And they have the temerity to turn him down. Twice! He has all the qualifications.
Yes, he's dead. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead.
Missed the first act.
Of what?
The magic flute. He's meant to be there, conducting.
Have to pick it up at the beginning of the second act now. Sarastro's aria. Basso profundo. Hell to sing.
100 times that I can be of more use to you here in Vienna than there in Salzburg. I implore you, dearest, most beloved father,
said that.
His father, in a letter.
To a creative genius? To an artist? These letters are appalling.
He wasn't an artist. I wasn't an artist. Only you were the artist, Ludwig. The rest of us were just jobbing composers trying to make ends meet.
But he'll die scrounging money off his friends. Not me. They want genius. They pay.
They did pay. He made about 11,000 florin over the last 6 years.
Really? $200,000. Where did it all go?
What's a dollar?
Bei Konzerte dieses Jahr am Burgtheater Gesamteinnahmen
Florins. Wie Konzert ist hier, heißt der Burgtheater, 900 Florins.
Konzerte in Berlin, in Frankfurt und in Dresden, a snuffbox, a watch, and 100 Florins.
Board and lodging, 250, hire the carriage is 100, change of horses.
Performance
of the Figaro in Januar 87, 1000 Florin. Journey to Prague, 250, an expensive apartment in the Schuhstraße. It's an rental is for 80.
Visionen für die Jungfern, Schauspieldirektor zu 25. Hochzeit des Figaro for 50.
Oh, the piano custom made.
It's a great 75.
200 ducats.
Oh, sie sind tutte 900.
That's 8,000.
Lovely men, sanity. Oh, 900.
That's 250.
Chamber composer to Joseph the Second.
Oh, for six every morning.
His papa insisted he always have a quartet or a sonata about him in case he bumped into a potential patron. Hardly ever wrote for himself, out of pure inspiration.
As if music were merely the family meal ticket. Calculate to the last crotchet.
When you make new acquaintances, you immediately wish to give your life and property to consider first the welfare of your parents, or else your soul will go to the devil.
You once said he'd go crazy if the letters didn't stop.
Perhaps he did. Listen to this. Letter to his father, February 1787. We are many sisters. It is painful for us to unite as well as to separate. We live in a palace, yet we could rather call it a prison.
Oh, yes. His carnival riddles. I never could get them at all.
He's trying to tell his father something in the riddle. Something he just can't come out with.
Thank you.
So his father had an all-consuming desire to control young Mozart. No wonder he fell into the arms of a woman.
Sophie, nicht Josefa, es ist Konstanze.
I send my 6 sons to you, most celebrated and very dear friend. These children may one day prove to be a source of consolation to me. Please then receive them kindly, and be to them father, guide, and friend. From this moment, I surrender to you, Haydn, my dear friend, all my rights over them.
He gave his children to you?
His quartets. He dedicated them to me, left them in my care.
How touching. And how well did you look after them?
Well,
Yes?
Well, they've been an inspiration to countless other composers.
An inspiration? What are you trying to say?
Oh, dear. I'm afraid there has been a breach of copyright.
What's copyright?
Thank you. Mozart String Quartet K428. Dedicated, as it happens, to me. My lord, the case against the defendant, Michael Lawrence Nyman, is, in a nutshell, that he has brazenly plagiarized the plaintiff's work and has committed what is, in effect, blatant intellectual theft. To wit,
Perhaps I'm deaf, but I fail to see the connection between these two pieces of music.
I would ask the court pianist if he would demonstrate how this piece of music has been concocted.
He has taken my chords. He slowed them down.
I call as witness for the defense the eminent 19th century Swiss composer and musicologist, Hans Georg Nägeli. Mr. Nägeli.
As you know, paraphrase has been for centuries a legitimate and respectable technique practiced by the greatest masters. And I quote from Czerny's School of Practical Composition, "The best method is undoubtedly that which Joseph Haydn himself recommended. You must compose according to chosen models, taking the same key, time, phrase, structure, number of bars, and even modulations, following them strictly.
And take pains to invent ideas, melodies, and passages quite different from each of the models chosen. I'm sure I said that as well.
So, all the music we have heard so far, composed by my client Mr. Nyman, has been based exclusively on specific Mozart models, according to the instructions of my learned colleague, Joseph Haydn. What Mr. Nyman has done is merely project these models 200 years into the future.
If the court pianist would kindly demonstrate.
Indeed. A distinct thread in Viennese musical tradition, which stretches from Haydn, Mozart...
Through your own works, Ludwig.
To the early 20th century, where Schoenberg, citing Brahms and Wagner as influences, also admired in Mozart the very thing.
Oh,
nothing but the rose on whose account I am born. I live with painful sensations for the
for the short duration of my life till I depart. Your own words, Mr. Mozart. Would you please tell the court what was the duration of your life?
I was born in 1756, and I died.
Yes. Go on. What Mr. Mozart finds understandably painful to accept is that he was born in 1756 and died a mere 35 years later in 1791. The tragic fact of the matter is that as far as litigation is concerned, even if there had been copyright in the 18th century, which sadly there wasn't, the plaintiff's music for more than 100 years has been out of copyright. Out of copyright.
He's missed the end now.
Something worthy of the fame I've acquired. But instead, I must die.
There it is, a fine double century from W.A. Mozart.